I know you've been asked a lot about coming back, but now that you're a couple of weeks in, has it been like a perfect fit, like putting back on a glove?
Oh, absolutely, man. I mean, from the moment I walked in to the facilities, obviously it's different, you know, some different people, but the love here and the culture here, it's stayed the same. And so, you know, you feel right at home when you come back.
Do you feel right at home on the field too? I mean, you obviously played a lot of football, but being able to come out here, just in the little time we've been able to watch, you look so comfortable running this offense in such a short period of time.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously taking time, and it takes a lot of work, man. It's not something that comes easy. It's a very complex offense that, you know, it's going to defeat a lot of defenses. So learning it has been a little bit of the difficult part. Maybe putting a little too much pressure on myself has been tough, but, you know, every single day I'm learning and I'm getting better. So, you know, that's all I can really ask for.
Why was coming back to BYU the right decision for you?
I mean, I think I got, you know, a matter of 7 months of being somewhere. And so it needed to be the best fit for my wife and I, and to be the most comfortable place where I could, you know, be the most successful and be part of a team that I know would care about me as much as I cared about them. And so as soon as you put that formula together and you're here and you visit here again and you see, you find out that's the right answer.
All right, I do want to ask you, the news of the day, the coaching staff announced that there's going to be two quarterbacks moving forward. This is probably something that through practices and reps you could probably tell, but with Tanner and Zach being the guys battling for that starting quarterback job, what does that do for the rest of you on offense?
Right. I mean, I think it just builds a rhythm, man. No matter who it is, whether it would have been Joe, whether it's, you know, Zach or Tanner, it really doesn't matter. As long as we have the opportunity to really build on a rhythm, that's what's going to create the success, and that's what's going to get us ready for what's 19 days until we're sitting in Tucson and ready to play a game.
What are you seeing from both of those guys, really from the start of camp?
I mean, I think just composure. I think that you see the root of what is Coach Roderick and Coach Grimes sitting on those guys and coaching those guys. You find out that they are very, very similar. And so it's awesome just to see how much they're latching on to what the coaches have to say. And they're not, you know, individuals. They're coaching each other up. They're helping each other out. And that's creating a more, you know, a stronger unit for us as an entire offense.
I think a lot of people have been pretty impressed that a freshman like Zach has been able to come in and be able to go toe-to-toe with some of these other guys.
Oh, absolutely, man. Like, it's unbelievable. I think there's a to be completely honest with you, I haven't seen a kid his age be so comfortable and so poised and know an offense and make decisions that he's making. I think that really the last person I saw do that as a true freshman was Tanner Mangum. And so to be able to watch that and to see that, they're very similar. And so to be able to have each other, to, you know, have Zach learn from Tanner, you know, it's an unbelievable prospect.
It seems like there were a lot of positives coming out of the scrimmage on Saturday, and coaches seem to be pretty pleased with the way that camp is going and progressing and at the point where you guys are you, as someone on the field, pleased with where this offense is right now?
Absolutely. I mean, it's hard to say, you know, it's not perfect, and that's something that I think that's one of my negatives is I want it to be perfect and I want everything to go smoothly, but it's not. And so, but where we're at and the progress that we're making every single day, I mean, we're in good shape.
So where are those things that you still feel you need to make the biggest jumps then before that game at Arizona?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's things that people are saying every single day, and that's just becoming, you know, more cohesive and having the chance to understand, you know, assignments from pre-snap in the huddle to the end of the play. And putting that all together as one play instead of just segments of each in different plays, as soon as we bring that together, and which I think we will here in the next couple days, so that, you know, come Arizona Day, we're going to be a well-oiled machine.
Over the last couple of weeks, we spent a lot of time on BYU Sports Nation talking about leadership and how important that is to a team. In watching you, you seem to have that ability to be a leader, whether it's on the field, whether it's talking to guys coming up to you, asking questions. How important is that for you to be a leader?
I think it's very important. It's important to me. It's important to others. It's not just a matter of me being a leader, but it's creating leaders around you. And so the ability that I have to really learn from these guys and to understand what's going on and, you know, the culture of this program, since it has been so long since I have been here. I'm learning a lot from guys and I'm learning how to be a leader in a different type of way. You know, it was how to be the good guy and how to do everything right at Hawaii. And now it's a matter of, okay, how can I do everything right and then add some extra detail to it? So, you know, it's extremely important, I think, because I am older and I have been, you know, I've been on the field for quite some time. It's an amazing opportunity, and, you know, I'm just grateful to be here.
Dylan, it's great to have you back. Thank you so much for the time, and good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you. Appreciate it.